Hello, everyone. So good to see you this week. Thank you for joining me for this office time chat with me. This is something that I do on a weekly basis, and I share insights and tips and advice that I have learned from numerous years of owning several businesses. And it's always great to see you join me on when I do these live little chats. And I see, hi Harold, thank you for watching. It's nice to see you here. Oh, and I see Esme. Hi Esme, nice to see you. And Kevin, hey Kevin, thanks for joining. Very much appreciate it. So what I'm gonna talk about today is a topic that's actually really important at this point in time. And that is about appreciation is good for business. And the reason I am focusing on that during our little office chat today is because as business owners, entrepreneurs, and founders, obviously we're managing a lot during this very surreal time, pretty much for everybody, not just on the business side, but also on the personal side. And it's very easy, of course, to let the stressors of running our business and all the things that come along with that during this time period to be kind of front and center. And you know, our employees are going through challenging times too. If you think about it, they're having, you know, whatever impact your business has had with respect to the COVID-19 stay-at-home orders and those kind of the economic impacts. So they're obviously undergoing their own stressors, and they also have their stressors related to their family members, friends, the isolation. There are studies that are showing that people are feeling a lot of depression right now. And I saw a study yesterday about how women employees in particular are really impacted, because not only are they trying to continue to do their job, but they're also obviously managing issues at home, childcare, homeschooling, parental care, extended family member care. And there are now studies showing, research that's showing, that women in particular are feeling a lot of stress. I see Stephen's joined us. Hi, Stephen. So what I wanted to focus on today is about appreciation. And it's really important at this particular time in our businesses, because appreciation is very directly correlated with job performance and with employee engagement. And I'm putting up a note here to share with you. Right now, when everyone's dispersed and working from different places and all the stresses that everyone is having, it can be really challenging to remember to show appreciation to your employees. And there's a difference between appreciation and recognition. And by that I mean, recognition is focusing on someone's performance. Hey Ronnie, thanks for joining. So recognition is someone's performance. Appreciation is conveying that you appreciate the value the person brings to your team and to your company. Two different things. So when you think of recognition, you know, think of things like certificates, you know, tangible things that are, that often are used in companies. But appreciation is about letting individuals know that you value them and they feel valued. Two different things. And here's what happens when you don't focus on appreciation. When you, let me reverse it. Here's what happens when you do focus on appreciation. It leads to employees having a much better feeling of culture and teamwork, and so it leads to higher levels of engagement. It leads to lower levels of turnover, absenteeism, higher levels of productivity, and therefore it positively impacts the bottom line. Hi, Gustavo, thanks for joining us. So to go through that again, showing appreciation, which is different than recognition, it leads to higher levels of engagement, lower levels of turnover, lower levels of absenteeism, higher levels of productivity, which equates to a positive impact on your bottom line. So what you might be interested in knowing too is that there are studies done that appreciate, everyone has an appreciation language. You've probably heard of that book, The Five Love Languages. Well, not surprisingly, people have their own way of feeling appreciated in the workplace. And often we think it's through monetary appreciation or through quote unquote gift giving appreciation. And everyone has their own language. Sometimes it's less about that and actually having a direct communication with someone on your team, giving them the opportunity to chat with you and letting them know how much you appreciate them and talking to them about how things are going. And you're there to support them and you're there to help them as much as you can. And those kinds of things really matter. So there's actually studies done that when individuals leave a job, this was a study done by the Department of Labor. When 69% of people who leave a job, the reason they state for leaving the job is because they didn't feel appreciated. It's not tied to their salary or their compensation. Now, I'm not saying, of course, that isn't important. Of course it is. But company leaders often focus on those kinds of things versus making sure that employees feel appreciated. So for myself, I've had to stay really focused on that. In fact, one of the things that I do is I give myself reminders periodically to just make sure I'm letting my employees know that they're appreciated through different ways, through direct communication, letting them know I appreciate their efforts and also how hard they're working under this extraordinary circumstance and that it matters and that I notice. Those kinds of things. There are other types of things that we do for recognition, for appreciation. But I actually give myself, put a couple of reminders here and there for myself to just remember to make sure that I'm focused on that and that my senior leadership team is focused on that. So this is really important right now, especially when everyone's under so much stress and we as founders and CEOs clearly are under stress ourselves. So I thought that this was a really good topic for this office chat with me, and that is about the fact that appreciation is good business. And remember, appreciation is different than recognition. I wish for you that you stay safe, that you stay healthy, that you continue to work through this challenging time. I share these office chats with you as part of my Possibility Architect Mentoring Program, which is a program I started to mentor, in particular, women employees, women founders, because I've been asked many times over the years about if I could mentor individual CEOs and founders, and this is the way that I've been able to set up to do that because I also run several businesses. So if you're interested in more tips and advice and things like this, check out possibilityarchitect.com. I have a free masterclass there. Oh, hey, Anna, good to see you. It's been so long since we've seen each other. So I hope you check it out. I hope you continue to join me for my weekly office chat with you. And if you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comment section and we will answer them probably in an upcoming office chat. Stay well.